Well, throughout the summer, we've been bringing you stories about how education doesn't necessarily end in May. This week, we travel to the far reaches of the Oklahoma Panhandle on a student paleo expedition. Here's our Lisa Hines.
You pick a little, and a little bit more, and just a little bit more to discover what might lie beneath the soil. Or not.
So it's not fossil.
Yeah, it is just sandy rock.
Called ExplorOlogy, students are exploring science by doing. Jess Cole is the head of education at the Sam Noble Museum and says it's all about dinosaurs.
One of the ways that we know that kids absolutely love is paleontology and fossils and dinosaurs. And so that was really just a natural, I guess, merging, is kind of getting kids excited about science through something they were already excited about, dinosaurs and fossils and things. So.
Which is why Mackenzie Sajeka is here.
Ever since I was a kid, I can remember having this fascination for dinosaurs and just prehistoric stuff.
For Amanda Harding, it's an adventure.
It's like a treasure hunt. That's the best way you can put it. It's a treasure hunt. You don't know what you're going to find, but you know it's going to be cool.
And it's a dream come true for Clay Dominy.
I've always been interested in paleontology and dinosaurs in specific. And as soon as I moved to Oklahoma and my parents found out that there was a two-week paleontology camp for high schoolers, I immediately knew I had to get involved. And I was really excited to come here and do this.
Learning about science, but with a fun twist.
This is the Paleo Expedition program. This program is really giving high school students the ability to engage and also be part of a field science experience before they go to college, in the hopes that it might help them understand what it is to be a field scientist.
And that just tells you it's crocodile. As opposed to...
This program, I think, is really vital and critical because it gives students the opportunity to do science. And maybe in some of our small communities, especially in rural and our urban areas, they really don't have the resources to provide students with this type of opportunity. So no other program that I know really gets the students outside in the field, not just studying or reading through books or looking at PowerPoints or lectures. And not only do we get to go out in the field, but we get to go back to the museum in the collections and labs to visit scientists, see what they're doing, taking part in the process, and just really understanding what science is all about.
Josie Garrard is the outreach program's coordinator for the Sam Noble Museum and says we all do science.
The main goal of ExplorOlogy is really to bring science to Oklahomans in Oklahoma and to make it applicable, to make it real, and to really show students especially that science is something that anybody can do. So I think it really does just kind of bridge the gap between the academic side of science and then the people. It kind of connects them and shows them how they work together and how they can be the same. So I think this is another thing that ExplorOlogy does, is it kind of turns on that switch and it lets people realize that, hey, I already am a scientist, so why not? Why not go into science? Why not pursue what I love?
A love that can get pretty dirty.
They're literally excavating, so they're getting in there with their tools, they're picking out bone, or they're clearing matrix, the soil around the bone, to try to just clear out and see what's what and where it is.
I think I've got a bone right there.
It is very hands-on, and that's the whole point of ExplorOlogy as a whole, but specifically Paleo Expedition, is that it is hands-on experience. It's not sitting in a room listening to a presentation. It's not reading a textbook or just watching it on TV. They are doing it, essentially. They're not just learning about science. They're out there doing it. Right now, they're actually working on a quarry. This is a quarry that they have set up for different educational programs, but especially for ExplorOlogy. So they're working with several scientists from the Sam Noble Museum, as well as from Oklahoma State University. And they are just doing what scientists do. They're just jumping on in there. They're excavating, not just for fossils, they're excavating just around the site to see what's there. And they're really helping these scientists do their research.
And the students are learning skills at the feet of the scientists.
We have so many wonderful mentors who volunteer their time, scientists from the museum, but also from other institutions across the state.
Like Ann Weil, associate professor of anatomy and vertebrate paleontologist at Oklahoma State University, who says she gets just as much from the students as she is giving.
The thing that keeps it fresh for me is other people's just wonderment and excitement about it. To be reminded every day by people who are coming to the site how incredibly special, how incredibly neato this is. It helps me maintain my own enthusiasm.
Wet and mildew,
and the students enjoy the interaction too.
Little bits of turtle bone in the cap right there that we left.
I love being able to hang out with the professors and the staff of Sam Noble and just getting to know them and learning all this information that I never would have come across unless I had actually joined the program.
It's a really great thing we can do, because it's one thing to get knowledge from someone who might have studied or may have picked up the trade a few years ago or something like that. Once you can see the professors who have done this their whole lives and are still doing it today, that really helps.
Now this dig is a bit unique to other dinosaur digs.
The site is really all entirely excavated by Oklahoma students, which makes it pretty unusual. There are a lot of dinosaur sites in the Morrison Formation, but this is the only one we can say is student excavated. And the professionals here are teaching people how to do it. We're not doing a lot of this excavation ourselves. That is partly the mission of the landowner, actually, and the landowner is very dedicated to science education in Oklahoma. But the condition of that was really that we use it as an educational site, and this is a very unique site in being sort of equally dedicated to education and to research.
But the lessons aren't only just about paleontology.
This week they'll be working with two other scientist mentors from the Sam Noble Museum. They'll be working with Nick Chapleski, who is the curator of vertebrate paleontology. And then they're working with Dr. Katrina Menard, who is the curator of recent invertebrates. So she does modern invertebrates, so arthropods and insects. But she also teaches them about ecology, just how ecosystems, modern ecosystems work.
The program is so popular that some students return, like Amanda Harding.
We had a lot of fun last year, and I just wanted to come back. You get a lot of experience, and I want to be a paleontologist, so that's the best thing I could do. It takes a lot of work, but in the end, it's worth it all. And if you're the one that uncovers that fossil, you're the first one to ever see it.
Now, this wouldn't all be possible without the collaboration with the Whitten-Newman Foundation. Jeff Hargrave is their director of operations.
Initially, the foundation helped create ExplorOlogy, and then sponsored all the programs. Since then, the ExplorOlogy program has taken off, and we, you know, assist with getting additional funding, and we provide this property for children to come and explore and dig for dinosaurs and all the ologies. That's kind of where we came up with the name ExplorOlogy, is explore all the sciences, and we try to get as many kids out here and explore as much as we can so they can learn as much as they can.
Giving kids a chance to see a possible future for themselves.
They really wanted to provide that opportunity so students could see not only what science was, but also maybe see it as a potential career path. We have had a lot of students go through the program, and recently we did do a survey that found that more than half of them are either in college right now or pursuing a science-related field in higher education. So we do feel that our program is not only very effective and fun for the kids now, but also has long-lasting effects.
It's great. How many high school students can say they've done this? I mean, it's a great experience.
This has, like, fueled my fire to become a paleontologist.
Digging through the past to find the right path to a future career.
Yeah, right around here.